Before we get started, I just want to show you guys my appreciation for the last video I uploaded, which is my custom zombie horse video. It made my day when I saw all the comments, all the likes. Generally, the reaction I got from my last video, I just wanted to say thank you so much. Now, let's get back to the video. Or in this case, let's get started with the video. Hello, dragons. My name is Dragonsnips, and I like to make tiny nerdy things. Oh wait, wrong channel.
Why do I regret this?
Hello, dragons. It's me, Dragonsnips, and I have a wooden pistol case that I stole from my sister without her knowing.
Hey,
you see this thing? Yeah, that thing. It's a round. You're probably wondering what the thing is for. And no, it's not carrying some sand pieces that you found outside. It was for these pair of glasses that came from this box alone. Yes, this box that had artwork exploding from its cover. I could practically see the artwork flying off the box. Whoa. But if you've seen this box, then you probably already know where this is going. But if you haven't seen this box, then you're missing out. Why do I keep saying that? This box is another crafting kit, but it's not from Nerdy Crafters this time around. This time, this kit is from Jazza. The last time I did something that I got in from Jazza, it was pretty much a year ago that I looked into the Illustration Pro kit that Jazza created, which are those illustrations in here. There we go. Remember that wooden case that I showed you in the intro of this video? Well, the sooner they laid my eyes upon its glory and its beauty, I immediately slammed it down onto my decks and pulled out some wire and sculpting supplies for me to actually start building. So here we are with the rest of the item I'll be using for this build. After making the basic body of some unfortunate monster that I'll be working on, but before I could put this basic of a monster together, I need a drill. You see this drill? You see this wooden case? I think you all know where this is going. So after drilling 4 holes into the wooden case, which could actually help put the entire base together and help me find my eagle, I proceeded to find my will to live with the basic body placement onto the wood. You see, I don't see anything wrong with this. Nothing at all. Just don't think about it. If you think about it, the war flashback will come back and haunt me. With my camera. I think it needs a re-examination. Or at least a better battery, because I am sick of changing out the battery whenever my camera glitch out. Is my camera a toddler or a Karen? Because I can't tell the difference between them half of the time. Anyways, back to the basic. When I mean basic, I mean basic wireframe and soft clay going on top of it. If you're using this clay, then you must be a massive kid. I cannot say that word. But who cares, we're moving on. This clay is really too damn soft for this. If you want something that feels like putty, then this clay is perfect for you. Only reason I have this white shit of a Play-Doh is for the reason to save money. Because this soft super Sculpty is cheaper than my college degree. I can use it to cover the entire body of this godforsaken milkshake. While I'm placing this clay on top of the wire base, a lot of people, more like two, stated in my last video that my audio was a bit hard to hear because of music. There's a problem. So I've turned the music down a whole lot, the point you can't really hear it. And turn my audio a bit up, at least I hope I did. I tend to forget stuff, so I'm still kind of learning with microphone and audio. I should have taken the time that I was trying to figure out my YouTube channel with it, but anyhow, I should also buy a new mic as well, maybe a new camera in the future. But that's then, this is now. I need to bake this guy in the oven, so yeah, we're gonna do that. So I'm gonna bake him and forget about him for 12 million years. So once I'm done baking him and not forgetting about him for 12 million years, it's time for me to cover this guy with a normal super sculpy medium clay. Which, why didn't I use it in the first place? Because I'm an idiot with no brain cells. No, wait. I thought it was cat. So after doing this multiple times, I don't know how long I've done this, and while I'm placing him back into the oven to be forgotten again for another 12 million years, or either 2 million years, I don't know, make make sure to go check out my social media. Do you like seeing photo of my artwork? Do you like seeing them before the video come out? Yes? Well, here's my social media site. Yeah, Tweedledee and Tweedledum. These are my dragonlings. And if you don't like dragons, well, bye! But dragon, what if I like your artwork so much that I want to steal it for myself? Well, please don't. But if you want my artwork so much that you want to steal it, Dragonsnips is not responsible for people stealing things, then check out my website where I sell some of my artwork, like these prints, or like these paintings. Is that a derpy horse? Don't forget this thing, and that goof over there! Artistry site, you can commission me for a character or a creature artwork or a painting. Also, fan art, can't forget about that. So what are you waiting for? Head on down to the description below or this icon here to check out my link tree to check everything out. And if you don't go to my link tree and now and check out everything I have to offer, I'll feed you to my dragonlings. Anyway, where was I? Ah yes, sculpting. Got more sculpting to do. And it's not like my fingers are falling off from many hours of sculpting this guy. Oh, and I need to add some tree legs to the wooden piece because, if you haven't realized it by now... Yeah, that pretty much sums it up. I think I'll go now. Bye! Now the legs are added, he can stand now! Well, not really. But it looks like the sculpting part is done now, right? Right? Wrong! We still have many hours of sculpting to go. But I don't think I'll skip this part for ya. The sculpting part is finally done. It only took me like 3 years to complete. I can finally use the gesso on him that the gesso came from the kit. I can grab out the container and open it up. Only one problem though. I can't open it. Maybe this might work. I don't think that's working. No matter how hard I twist the freaking lid or how hard I slam it on top of the table, even using a big plier to get the damn thing open, I still couldn't get it open. Pussy! I think some of the gesso dried up near the lid. The gesso inside the container is still liquid. So I think I'll go with my own gesso. So I'll just went ahead and added a millionth layer of the white gesso on top of this guy. Not like I have a life to focus on or school to go to. And gee, was it all worth it to add a millionth layer of gesso on top of this guy? Kind of. This is how he turned out after some layers, I guess. You failed basic math. But fair, kind of hard to get to some of the corner because of how I sculpted him. Also, I wanted to get to his general painting part because... And I did eventually manage to open this container after a million ways to break into it. Good thing I didn't use a saw. Now it's time for painting, and let's get on to that right now. Oh, for the love of everything that is artistic. Is that going to happen every often? Is it? Well, I guess I must get used to it then. You guys too. If I have to suffer through this, so do you guys. Maybe a new camera will come into play. Now that I cover him with gesso, wait, we already did this part. We need to paint him now. So I started painting the tree trunk because, well, I don't know what to paint him. I'm a bit in a panic here. So while I'm painting the tree, I'm trying to think of what color to paint him. Okay, the tree is almost done and I still have no idea what to paint him. And maybe I'll have an idea then. Okay, now I just need to look through my phone off camera to see what I want to paint him. And oh look, I think I have an idea. I'll paint him red. Yeah, that'll work. I won't be changing that at all. Not going to change it. Yep. I think this is a perfect- I don't like this color! I'm going to take it outside and spray it over. Okay, that's done, and I painted the tree off camera. Let's add in some pastels. Now only $29.99! Yeah, I sprayed it down with 3 layers of Mr. Super Clear and added a few colors to its base. Although I feel like some of the color didn't show up well with its base, I blame the weather for this. Darn you! Weather! Problem with the weather, I wasn't able to finish adding pastel to the tree trunk. Now time for me to add a wash to it. Should I have done this before I added the pastel? Maybe. I probably should have, but what's done is done. I can't travel back in time. So I'll add in the wash to the tree trunk. Nothing will go wrong. Oh. It's covering some of the progress I did with the pastel. and it didn't get, went into all the contents of the tree. Let's not focus on that. Now time for the book. After, like, you know, the problem with the red paint, I finally have the color for him. I had to draw him out and put him through my computer just to figure out the colors. His face! I was finally able to find a color theme that I really like about him, because when I was trying to figure out his color theme, a lot of people recommended, like, friends and family, like, red, blue, purple, and I'm like, I wanted something natural with him, so when I finally got this color, I instantly fell in love with him. I'm like, okay, this is his color. Okay, so let's get to his color then. I mixed a few colors with brown to get this color, then I did his body with green and peachy color and a bluish black to his body. I really like this color match. I don't know how you guys would feel about this color theme, so let me know what you guys think about it. And yes, I didn't really record the painting part because, the tummy problem started happening. I got sick and I barely painted this guy while I was sick in bed watching the latest Husband Hotel episode. But despite me getting sick, I finally was able to finish the painting. Finally, now time for me to sip on my favorite Arizona drink! What? Yep, we're not done with this madness! I still must blush this guy from the top to the bottom. I sprayed this guy down with 3 layers of Mrs. Super Clear and started the blushing part. And I also protected the tree trunk from all of the blushing with the masking fluid, because I didn't want to redo the hard work I've already done with the tree. And let's just hope that this masking fluid doesn't bite me back in the butt later on. After I place all the masking fluid on top of the tree to make sure nothing will get on top of the tree, and waited for the masking fluid to dry, it was time for me to pull out all the color I wanted to use for the stick bug monster. I think I need to come up with a better monster name for this guy because I have no idea what to call him. If you guys have any suggestions, please let me know. I kind of blush him off camera just a little bit to kind of base how I wanted to do this, but I recorded the rest of the process on camera so that way I could get some footage of me, you know, blushing. And when I was blushing him, I wasn't really particularly happy with how the blushing process was going. But I'm just like, I'm just gonna trust the process to see how where this goes and how I would do it and all that stuff. So I just continue with the blushing and more blushing, more layers of MSC, more layers of matte varnish. I don't know if the matte varnish is really working with darker areas. I'm still kind of figuring that out. So I kind of added like blues, green, yellow, red, and I'm really grateful I added the red, orange, and yellow to the tree. I thought I would try to mash the color with the actual color that I picked, but the more I tried going with the colors that I picked for the body, the more it started not looking right, so I picked random blushing colors for the blushing part, I guess, if that makes any sense. I don't know. And for the mouth and phone, I'm just going to, like, wash both of them when I'm done with this. And maybe I might do dry brushing. There won't be any dry brushing after this. Again, I want to thank you guys so much for the response that I had gotten on the last video with me customizing my zombie horse. Lucy is her name. And yes, she is proudly on my stand here right next to me when I'm recording this voiceover. Hi, Lucy. He's a combination of human, stick bug, wasp, and praying mantis. I still don't have a name for him. And with that, after adding onto the last of the blushing under the guy, adding wash to both his mouth, teeth, I did that off camera. I added, like, decor on top of the tree. My camera died halfway through that, so I didn't get a chance to, like, record the rest. I did a lot of stuff off camera. But with that, we are finally done. Also, I freaking hate this part! am so happy with how he turned out. I mean, he's big, and I had a hard time trying to find a place for him to stay after this video was done. But I am so happy with how he turned out. I had planned originally for this guy to be the Flamster, but I decided to change it to this creature, and it turned out really well. I'm really happy. I'm happy with the blushing beside his antenna. I'm not really happy with his antenna blushing, but I'm just happy overall with this thing. I'm kind of saddened that the wooden, case shrunk in the oven. Yeah, it shrunk in the oven, which is why I opened the top and, earlier on in this, making of this guy. Because he shrunk, the lid would not be able to come off anymore, so I just put them all together, and now it's this. With Larry, Matthew, oh wait, I already have a character named Matthew. Never mind, we can't use that. I don't think this is what Jazza intended, but I did keep, it open so that way I can store stuff in. I could put my pencil in it. Wait a minute, the watercolor pens. You can add paint palettes into this. You can even add popsicle stick into this if you wanted to. You can even add your sculpting tools into this. I don't know. Do what you want. But overall, I really don't think this is what Jazza intended this to be, I guess? The kit came with Posca pin, these things. And paintbrushes and gesso. I don't think he intended us to sculpt on top of it, but I did. Because I really wanted to challenge myself because I don't like myself when it comes to art. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching, and I really hope you enjoyed this video. Also, please let me know what you guys think about the video editing style, I guess is that how I call it. Also, what do you think about the animation? Should I stop the animation? What do you think of my Red Eye series? Do you care about my Red Eye series? Should I have it as a separate thing? I don't know. Let me know down in the comment below. Now, leave your dragons forever. Bye, dragons!